Good morning, everyone. Welcome for this very intimate session. You've been very brave. I wanted to thank you Mehdi for this great introduction for my session. So our platform, the New Black, for banks and insurance. That's what I'm going to talk about, for the next 20 minutes and share some thoughts and ideas on platforms. Maybe it works. Just maybe start with a number you have to keep in mind, 60 trillions. That's according to McKinsey, the share of the global revenues that will go through platforms and ecosystems in 2025, 2030. This is a huge number of money that will go through for platforms and will go through APIs. And if we just, take a minute to talk about ecosystems, that's according to McKinsey, the main ecosystem that will drive the world in the next 10 years. Those ecosystems are organized around basic human needs, and they are served by platforms and digital players, of course, but also new emerging platforms. And those ecosystems, they are connecting, of course, multiple organizations. And what you have to keep in mind is that, if we compare with the traditional industries, okay, those ecosystems, the boundaries of those ecosystems, are going to disappear because, digitization, APIs, will connect a customer experience from one ecosystem to another one. And also, alongside the rise of ecosystem, you have the super apps emerging, especially in China or in Asian markets, where those super apps are able to deliver a very tailored and customized experience the marketing of one at the cost of the mass market. Of course, those super apps, are really the application is going to really your coach or going to be your companion, on a daily basis, from the morning to the evening. They will connect you to your bank accounts, of course, but also to your entertainment applications and thousands of other services. Coming back to the platform revolution, for what's happening with platform is really, the ability to connect multiple producers to consumers, and also to have those double-sided market where producers are consumers and consumers are sometimes also the producers. So I guess with Mehdi, we read the same books. We have this great book from Van Eltsine, this guy, from the MIT now is professor at the Boston University. Who has explained, very early how platforms are going to revolutionize, the industry and the business. So now, let's talk about, the bank, and how platforms are going to reshape, the banking industry. I'm not going to go through, each picture here, but what you have to keep in mind, that there's something special about, our banking industry. This is the DSP2 regulation, where that makes mandatory for the banks, to open, some data and to open that data through APIs. To allow third party to aggregate account information and also to initiate payments. Okay, and really, what we see also is that the customer expectations, which have been standardized by the digital, players like Amazon or Uber, are now, what our clients are expecting from the banks. That's changing everything. Also, we have new competitors. We have Stripe. We have Klarna, that has been mentioned in the presentation before. But we see also for Tesla, a car maker, okay, that is offering, for insurance as part of the customer journey when someone is buying a Tesla. And of course, to do that, well, we need technologies. Okay, we need artificial intelligence. We need data, and we need APIs. And I will come back on this in a minute. But also, we need new people to be able, you know, to change the way we do business and how we're going to address those markets. So it's a very deep impact, a deep change for the industry. So. Of course, APIs, you know, are the fuel or what the connectors of the platform economy. They are they give us the ability for a bank, you know, to be part of a third-party third-party customer journey when we provide consumer credit, for example, to an e-merchant, or to the ability for a third party to aggregate banking information about you and provide you know some information on how you can better you know save your money or insurance insure yourself. Those other APIs, of course, will connect you know the banking world to other platforms, to other ecosystem. So. Basically, you know, if we look at the banking industry, what's happening? We're moving from a very tailored integration with our third-party partners. For example, we do provide, you know, consumer credit to retailers, okay? But now, progressively, we move to an API automation, you know, where to integrate with third parties, where we can provide services through API. This is the first move. Of course, this is really not only at BNP Paribas. You know, most banks are doing the same. And also, now we're going to really to move toward you know a world where APIs you know will deliver the services, but also will allow us to do customized you know services to each partner. So it's at the same time standard. But also the ability to deliver specific services tailored to the partner needs. On the right, which is the next move, is how a bank can become a platform itself, providing its services and its products alongside with third-party services and products, and including some of our competitors, and how we can be the platform orchestrator. I will give you an example in a minute. I'm just checking the time, so that's fine. So the first thing we did is very simple, actually. We just opened last year the BNP Group API store, where we do provide APIs to third-party partners, fintech, insurtechs, other banks, you know, so they can, you know, connect to the bank accounts and also initiate payments. It's a very first step. But this the store has had a huge benefit on the internal transformation. The store, you know, all the people working, you know, the community working around the store, you know, was able to raise awareness within the company to really understand, you know, what is at stake with the APIs. Of course, the store, you know, aims at offering, you know, a one-stop shopping for partners to just, you know, really find you know the right APIs for their services. This is just a beginning. We have a great ambition with the store to really provide you know all the APIs that we have within the bank. We are in 70 countries. We are a universal bank, and our ability to provide you know value-added services to our customers is great. But that's just the beginning of the story. You know, platforms and for bank is also an opportunity to start to move to adjacent services. When you talk about you know bank accounts, finance, you can offer accounting services, payroll services, and other services. So really, the move for the banks is going to be able to, as a platform to provide you know adjacent services for small enterprise, for example. You know, when you are an entrepreneur, okay, you don't have time to waste with accounting, payroll, and things like this. If we can provide, you know, an end-to-end seamless journey to those entrepreneurs, you know, so that they have no worries about, you know, that administrative things, you know, which needs to be done, and they can focus really on their business. So that's really the trend within the bank industry. So just to give you a very example, I'm sorry, it's in French. It's the BNP Paribas in France, where we have launched this platform for entrepreneurs, you know, where they can connect with everything they need to start their company. Okay, and of course they have a special rates if they go through this platform. There are some blockchain behind this, actually, not only API. So we can make sure that the entrepreneur coming through this portal, you know, is going to benefit from the specific tariff we have negotiated with the provider. So it's really a beginning. Okay, we're moving forward. We're going to have other platforms like this in other countries. Another example I like very much, it's in Poland. We now have we are a major bank in Poland now, it's BNP Poland, and we have a huge customer segment with the farmers, okay? And we, of course, we do find on those farmers, but now we offer with this agronomist platform, you know, just a variety of services that help those farmers to really monitor and to help them, you know, to operate the farms with, of course, weather services, expertise on crops, and stuff like that. Okay, so we're connecting, you know, for various providers and services through a unique platform, and to help our customers and also new customers. So it's quite far away from the banking, but we have this legitimacy for that type of customers in Poland, you know, to offer that type of services. Another example which is coming, it's called Manaus. It's in the very specialized industry of securities, where we want to offer a place where we're going to be able, you know, to connect, you know, all the services you need in the security services. I mean, it's a safe place where we're going to keep the securities of third party and other stakeholders, and it's going to be launched soon. And it's really totally API driven services that we're going to provide. So the idea was to give you some, you know, examples of what we're doing at BNP Paribas, where we're really to tackle the issue of platformization and API.
All right, thank you. Questions for Laurent? No hands yet? All right. I've been wanting to run up these stairs.
Yeah, quick question about like the relationship of banks with neobanks, or we know with people who may consume your APIs to re-own the interface and re-own the customer experience on the store you do. What's the relationship actually you want to build with these companies? What will you allow them to own, and what's BNP at some point wants to keep, and what's the let's say the social contract with these API users that you expect to have?
Thank you for the right question. basically, you know, I think, you know, first of all, we've been, you know, building for the past 3 years, you know, a strategy of how we can work with the ecosystem, the startup ecosystem. We're very well known, you know, to be fintech friendly in the right competition mode, you know, and we work with many fintech in France, in Europe, in the rest of the world. Okay, so that's the first. That would be my first answer. Now we I think it's also test and learn process. Okay, there's no definite final answer to this. And some places we think, you know, that we will be best to provide, you know, the end-to-end seamless journey and offer the ability to fintech, insurtech, or other startups or other providers, you know, to integrate a white label or not our customer journey in other places, we will be the provider. So basically, you know, I think we have two legs here, being a smart providers, okay, through APIs, okay, where we think it's going to add value for the customers and bring revenues for the bank. And in other places, we think we'll be the best position to offer the to offer the hand-to-hand, you know, customer journey. And that's the type of discussion we have with some of the newcomers, new bank, and players coming to the bank industry.
Do you plan to monetize your APIs?
Yes, of course. Right now, we have two types of APIs. You know, we have basically the DSP2 APIs because they are mandatory. Okay, so they are free. And of course, you know, on top of that, we have the ambition to add, you know, features, value-added features that will be premium APIs. It's not an easy move. Okay, because it's going to change the way we do business and we generate revenues, okay, versus the traditional way of generating, you know, revenues. So that's something we're learning, you know, along the way with talking with some new partners and the fintechs that I was talking about. But yes, that's the that's really the objective. Yes, of course.
You showed an example in Poland, where you went far outside of what you would consider banking, right?
Yeah.
What are some ways that, beyond just publishing our APIs and then others can find them, what are some ways that we can think more holistically about our customers and how our APIs could partner to help our customers?
Basically, I mean, you know, what, you know, there's two moves here, okay? There is, you know, within the banking industry, okay, within what we offer to our customers to improve, you know, what we do through APIs, our own APIs, and also the ability to consume third-party APIs. So that's, you know, the how we're going to change and transform the core business. Okay, and there is another, you know, another side of the thinking, you know, as how really we can, you know, address new ecosystems, the ecosystem I was, you know, mentioning before, and to rethink totally our position. Okay, and bring you know, new services to customers that we don't bring, you know, today. I mean, there are many ecosystems that we could explore. For example, I think, you know, in this and this in the the context we know, I think helping people to prepare the their retirement, which is a very hot subject now, we can really rethink, you know, and really stretch the value proposition. But at the start of this is, are we legitimate to do that? Okay, because people are going to trust the bank to do this. You know, in the payment industry, for example, basically, you know, when you see, you know, Facebook, for example, that has which is able to deliver this great, you know, customer experience. Okay, but are you going to trust them with your own data? Are you going to trust them, you know, for payment and things like that? You know, so I think, you know, everything is going to relate to the trust, are we legitimate, you know, to offer new services even far away from the core banking. I think there are many opportunities out there, okay, and the technology and APIs will help us, you know, to address things that we haven't thought before.
Great, thank you. Oh, we have time, so we'll We'll take one more.
Thank you. Hello, and thank you for your speech. What I noticed that you were talking about services, while I think the banks traditionally are product-oriented companies. And how do you deal with this transition? It's not easy, but it's different channels, different way to talk to the potential customers. The portals is not sufficient, I think, to call, come and buy. I mean, they may come but may not buy. How do you deal with that?
Yeah, I totally agree. I mean, this is exactly you very well summarized one of the our challenges is how we move from a product company to deliver experience. We really start to do that. For example, when I was talking about the Lancez-vous platform, is how we're going to help customers not just consume products, but provide customer journey, seamless customer journey, where we're going to integrate third party services. Just to give you an example, what we're trying to do now is really to stick to events. It's really event life, driven, customer journey. When you're going to get married, when you're going to move and buy a home, okay, and how we can provide a smooth, services. That's going, of course, we're going to help you to buy the home of your dream, but also we're going to help you, to move. We're going to connect you with the best providers for your new home. It's how we're going to connect you. Plenty of different services, that going to make this life event smooth and easier. So really the idea is really to move from selling a product, a credit, okay, to a rich and seamless experience to make this life event not difficult and not painful. So just to give you an example with the home environment, but we have many others where really we're trying to achieve this move from product provider to service providers.
All right, thank you very much.